Thank you for joining Wars of the Roses. And in this video, we'll be reading the Rosicrucians, What They Are and What They Are Not by R. Swinburne Clymer. The Rosicrucians, What They Are and What They Are Not. A declaration, an accusation, a challenge. Think not that I came to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. St. Matthew 10:34. Let the truth be known. Responsibility. This booklet is written by the president of the Royal Fraternity Association Incorporated, registered in Pennsylvania, who is personally responsible for every statement contained herein. Correspondence relative to the Rosicrucians should be addressed to the Department of Instruction, Beverly Hall Corporation, Beverly Hall Building, Quakertown, Pennsylvania. Prelude. The Rose Cross. Our claims. This fraternity or association of men claims without any reservation, qualification, or exception whatsoever to possess sole jurisdiction over all Rosicrucian affairs, general and particular, irrespective of the special or peculiar phraseology relative to the name, title, appellation, nomenclature, Greek or Latin derivative by which the order, fraternity, brotherhood, or society is known in America, and all her possessions and her island possessions, and defies successful contradictions of its rights and authority to such possession, and the presentation of one single honest claim to the contrary by any person or persons whosoever. Basis of this right. The possession of this power and authority was obtained by the various leaders, teachers, and priests of the fraternity by right of having legitimately enrolled in the August fraternity, by having been properly and thoroughly instructed, fully trained, and finally initiated. Also by right of being properly authorized and commissioned prior to the institution of the order on American soil, and by the continuous existence of the order since its establishment. A trial and an admission. In 1872, while Dr. P.B. Randolph, then the Supreme Grand Hierarch of the Rosicrucians, lived in Boston, and long years before any other association in America or any of her possessions attempted to use the name Rosicrucian in one or another of its variations, some of Dr. Randolph's enemies tried to ruin him and his work and the order. The prosecuting attorney, during the course of making his charge to the jury, said, "Over 20 years ago, Dr. Randolph was known to be a Rosicrucian, and in that period, he ascended the steps of the mystical brotherhood, outstripping the thousands and rushing past hundreds of gray beards in the mental race until he attained the chieftainship of the true Rosicrucians in America and the Isles of the Sea, and finally to the supreme high priesthood of the order and the grand mastership of the combined lodges of the earth, likewise reaching the double office through his absolute defiance of poverty and wealth and persistent pursuit of ideas alone." Setting aside the admitted 20 years prior to 1872, there is no record of any other association of men functioning as Rosicrucians, and in addition to the proofs by copyright and in existing books, this public trial and its records prove beyond contradiction the existence of the order, the undisputed authority of the said Dr. P.B. Randolph as Supreme Hierarch, and his right to appoint his own successor, teachers, and priests, and the consequent illegality of any other men or body of men forming an association or associations and using the name or title Rosicrucians, unless appointed by Dr. P.B. Randolph or his legitimate successors. During Dr. P.B. Randolph's Grand Mastership, the See and the House of SS of the Triple Order was located in San Francisco, Boston, and Toledo, in the order named. During the life of Freeman B. Dowd, the see and the House of SS of the Triple Order was located in Arkansas first and later in Mexico. With the induction of Dr. Edward H. Brown into the chair of the Grand Master, several changes were made and the see and House of SS of the Temple of the Rosy Cross and Euless was moved to Salem, Massachusetts. While the see and House of SS of the Order and Fraternity of the Rosicrucians was located at Beverly Hall, Quakertown, Pennsylvania, and in the year 1910, a special temple was constructed for the express purpose of holding the June and All Souls Night convocations. With the passing of Dr. Brown, all authority of the Triple Order became vested in the present Supreme Grand Master, whose authority is of triple derivation and dissension, directly from Dr. P.B. Randolph, through his heir and associate, and through Dr. James R. Phelps, and equally directly from the Supreme Hierarch, Count Genotti, the master and teacher of Marie Corelli, who conferred full authority of the International Illuminati upon Dr. Phelps. And at present, the see and the House of SS of the Triple Order is located at Beverly Hall, Quakertown, Pennsylvania, at which place and in the reconstructed Temple of the Order, the convocations are held twice each year. Fallacious reasoning. Apparently, sincere and deeply interested students sometimes question whether it is wise to attempt an expose of clandestine bodies, leading to the belief that the better way would be to ignore these, arguing that each, students as well as organizations, being at his own particular stage of evolution, he will work up through it, so why concern oneself? If such reasoning were logical and in harmony with divine law, then we should likewise say, why form international associations for the control of the sale of narcotic drugs, looking to a reduction of the number of victims of this fearful scourge, since each individual is at his own stage of evolution and therefore in need of this experience, which in 99 cases out of 100 results in total destruction of body and soul. Why not give the manufacturers and purveyors full freedom to sell their deadly drugs to all who will buy? Or again, why have physicians at associations for the purpose of reducing the number of diseases and their victims? Why not, seeing that each one is at his own stage of evolution and therefore needs just this experience, let things go on as they are, permitting epidemics to sweep the country as black cholera did in the past? Or why have churches and ministers to point out to people those acts which are sins, destructive of body and soul, and lead to death? Why fight the devil or evil? Why not give him every chance in the world, seeing each individual's soul is at its own stage of evolution and should pass through this experience? If it is our duty to fight or overcome anyone evil, then each and every evil should have like attention at our hands. And these evils, which affect the soul even to its destruction, as do false occult teachings, which are the most greatly destructive, should have our attention first. Students who, without vigorous protest, permit false teachings to flourish, teachers who even clothe themselves with the names of honored associations, names to which they have no right, such students are disloyal to their order and their master. They are negatives or semi-negatives, and in great danger of falling under the sway of the black brotherhoods and their elusive doctrines and seductive but false promises. Evil must be met face to face and handled without gloves. To compromise is to be lost. That which is either is right or wrong. There is no middle path. Not a pleasant duty. It is not a pleasant duty to accuse or contradict or to engage in contention. And these things are to be avoided whenever possible. However, it becomes a holy duty thus to do when that which is sacred is parodied before the public and degraded by misuse. It has been frequently said that if one is clothed with truth and in the right, then that is all that is sufficient, and the law ultimately will right the wrong. In theory, this is admitted, But in the meantime, a countless army is misled, many beyond redemption. Even the great master teacher admitted by practical action. As note, when he chastised and drove forth the money changers in the temple, that there are times when the truth must be openly defended, and when those who debase things that are holy must be confounded with the truth and brought to justice and righteous punishment. Think not that I am come to send peace on earth. I came not to send peace, but a sword. St. Matthew 10:34. Justice. Thus, while it is the mission of the Rose Cross to bring peace and spiritual insight to the seeking, wondering, yet sincere soul, and to lead it to illumination and immortality, in the present instance, even as was the master teacher of old, to unsheathe the sword and carry it unsheathed until the false teachers and self-appointed leaders who pose as members of the order are driven from the temple of the Rosy Cross. Thank you for watching. I'll finish this reading sometimes in the future. Please don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and comment.